I'd like you to comment on the Black Lives Matter movement and how
oh,
it
yeah, I got some words for that.
How it actively obscures men's issues because it's really black men and it's their maleness, not just the race.
Yeah, can I just jump? I'm not black. I'm not black. But I got something to say.
You got light skin privilege.
Yeah.
I
did my 23andMe and I'm 24% Sudanese, so I'm pretty African, okay? So 50% Iberian and 0.05% Ashkenazi Jew, so I know what I'm talking about. So woo! Okay, anyway. Black Lives Matter is not an organization that is interested in the suffering of black people. And they are, if you go to the website, just go to the website and look at their mission statements and look at what they actually, their core principles. That's like the best way to find out whether or not an organization has the best interests of whatever it is that they claim to have. BLM is an intersectional feminist group. They actually prioritize black women over black men. And let me explain why that's strange. There's nothing wrong with loving black women and caring about them, obviously. But you built a movement that started because black men were being killed. Okay? Whether you think that it's justifiable or not, that's not the point. Because the narrative is, you know, evil racist cops, evil racist government is killing black men. And then you start the movement, and then within the people who started the movement, by the way, three women, intersectional feminists, black women, they call them, have you ever heard of, I think they're called black feminists or Afro feminists, but anyway, it's a different, huh? Oh, womanists, that's right, womanists, right. They started it, I forget their names. And if you look at it, it's all about, it talks about support for women of color, LGBTQ people of color, everything except men. Actually, men are not even listed in the people that they claim to care about. Imagine the people in your group, in your tribe, die, and then you form a movement that's based on their deaths, but in your manifesto, you don't mention those people at all. And that's Black Lives Matter. And to go further with it, there are a lot of Black Lives Matter sort of adjacent websites that talk about these issues. There's one website, you may have heard of it, called The Root. You ever heard of The Root? And they put out an article, and they put a lot of really, really cancerous shit on this website. But this one was entitled, Black Heterosexual Men Are the White People of Black People. So that means that the men who are dying, that are being killed, that start the movements, are also the most oppressed, the biggest oppressors of the people within that subculture, within that racial group, you could say.
And the most privileged.
And this is actually the reason why I don't like talking about men's issues from a race perspective, because feminists always, why don't you talk about black men, or why don't you talk about Hispanic men? And I'm like, because the most important group is men, and I can put it to you this way. If you want people to pay attention to men's issues, you may have to point them at men that look like us and like that are suffering in order for people to even start to give a shit about men that look like you. And why is that necessary? If we stopped, look at it like this too. Take the data. So there's all this statistical data about the survivability of brown men and black men, but they don't describe them as brown or black men. They just say blacks, which includes women for some reason. Even though women are far less likely to be victims of violent crime, whether they're black or not. And they say this is a racial problem. But if you took that same data and you just looked at men, no matter what the race is, no matter what the color is, no matter what their ethnicity or their culture, and you lumped all of that data together, then you'd really have something to talk about. But that might be the reason why they don't want to talk about it.
Can't you see it too? There's an elephant in the room.